Getting user input can be like the trickiest thing when you're first starting to learn how to code. So in this video, I'm gonna teach you how to get string input from a user in Java. Hey, it's Alex back again, helping you code quicker and easier with program examples. On this channel, I make videos just like this all the time, so if you're new here, consider subscribing. Let's make a new project, as we always do. Go to File, New Java Project, and we'll call it our Pokemon Party, because that's the program we'll be making today. Hit Finish, open it up, and go to New Class. And we'll call it our Party, because it's a party up in his A. What is input? Input is anything that the user wants to tell the computer. To get input from a computer, we can type this one line of code in Java. And it's called a scanner. So we'll type scanner, and we'll name our scanner. We'll just call it scan. And we'll set it to a new scanner, like that. And ignore these red lines. We're just gonna put system.in in here. And I'll explain everything in a second. And pretty much what this is saying is we're gonna get input from a user with this thing called a scanner. And where are we gonna get the input from the user? Well, we're gonna get it from this console right here. So that's what system.in means. And this is underlined because we need to tell Java, hey, we're gonna be getting input from a user with the scanner. So we're kind of set up. So let's just ask our user, or ourselves. Don't tell them that it's just ourselves, okay? We'll tell the user to enter something. And we'll enter our Pokemon party, because in this program, we're gonna build our perfect party of 6 Pokemon. So we'll go enter Pokemon 1, like that. Now we'll get the input from the user and store it into a variable called Pokemon 1. And that's gonna be a string. So we'll say our string Pokemon 1 equals whatever the user types in. And whatever the user types in, we do scan, which is our scanner object, is stored in this keyword, which gets it from the console. So we'll do scan.nextLine, like that. And this gets the next line that the user inputs. And so when they hit enter, it'll be stored into Pokemon 1. So let's save it and run it just to see what happens. Okay, we're prompted to enter Pokemon 1. I like Arcanine, so I'm gonna put Arcanine into my party and hit enter. Cool, so nothing happened, but Java stored this Arcanine into Pokemon 1. And if we actually printed this out, if we printed out Pokemon 1, save and run, well, I gotta change it. Well, let's do an example. Let's say Typhlosion. Typhlosion. I think that's how you spell it. Typhlosion. Yeah, and then we print it out. So it's in the program now. Let's just get the other 5, and we can just do that by copying and pasting this a few more times. Oh, it looks so messy. Put some spaces, and then we'll change it to, let's make it bigger. Ooh, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and we'll store them in the respective variables, 4, 5, and 6. And let's put that semicolon there. We'll save it and run it just to see how it's going. Let's add that Typhlosion in again. Pokemon 2, we have a Lantern, I like Lantern. Flygon maybe, what's a good grass type? I'll put Meganium. Man, I didn't think this through. Tyranitar. Oh, I already have. Oh, Rock Dark. That's good. And then maybe a Gengar. Gengar. Oh, I accidentally hit enter, so it kind of made it mess up. Not cool, man. You'll experience stuff like this all the time when you program. So pretty much what I did is I hit enter, and then it thought that I put nothing, and then it stored that into Pokemon 6, and then the program quit. And that's what we expected. I mean, it's just kind of neat. So let's just confirm that these are the 6 Pokemon that you actually entered. So we'll just do that. Just like this, we'll do Pokemon 1. Pokemon 1. Copy, paste, 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 paste. And we'll print out 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And then we'll just say, here are your Pokemon. Here are your Pokemon. Pokemon. Here are your Pokemon. Okay, save it. Don't worry if you didn't get all this. I have the code linked in the description. So you can just copy and paste it into your IDE, Integrated Development Environment, fancy name for Eclipse or whatever program you're running code in. We'll save it, run it, and then go through it again. So what's another Pokemon? Let's do Flygon, Tyranitar, Arcanine, Charizard, Wailord, and what else? We'll do Shuckle. Shout out to Brett and hit enter. And then here are our Pokemon. We got Flygon, Tyranitar, Arcanine, Charizard, Wailord, Shuckle. Nice. Question of the day. Let me know what 6 Pokemon would make up your perfect party. Let me know in the comments and engage with this community of new programmers. Make sure to subscribe so you see all my newest videos the day they come out. And if this was helpful, smash that like button and share it if you think it might help someone you know. You could be anywhere in the world, but you're here with me and I appreciate it. Catch you.